Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing another pick a card. This pick a card is going to be all about your love life in 2021. I am very excited for this reading. It's going to be really in depth. I'm going to give you all the tea, all the advice and all the information. We have the Tiger's Eye, we have the Black Onyx and Hematite. We then have the Howlite and Rose Quartz. So please choose your bracelet. And let's get started. So starting off with group number one with the Tiger's Eye bracelet. Hello, group number one. Let's get started with your reading. So you guys chose this beautiful Tiger's Eye bracelet. I'm gonna try and show you a bit more up close so you can see it. My lights may be muting the colors, but it's really, really pretty. So for you guys who chose Tiger's Eye, I feel like as if it's really a strong energy of you guys moving forward. So Tiger's Eye is all about Aries. It's the fire sign, it's ruled by a fire sign. It's all about the solar plexus and your sacral chakra. So for you guys, it's really about moving forward, intense change, action, and can be frustration as well. So it can be a bit of that, but I do feel as if there's deep, strong, fast movement coming in for you guys. So we're gonna have a look at the tarot in just a second. And then we're gonna have a look in the oracle cards first of all. So let's have a look and see the main oracle cards, and then we're gonna have a look into the astrology ones. So the first card we have is don't dim to fit in. How are you dimming your light in order to fit in? And then we have the temple and the queen. Okay, gave myself a bit more room because I was starting to feel a bit cramped. There we go. I feel as if there's a part of you that you are releasing. I feel like it's all about focus, where you're putting your focus, where you are putting your attention. And I do feel like you guys may have a short attention span or your focus can kind of get drifted off quite easily. So for you guys within your relationships and your love life, I feel like this is all about self-love. This is about putting yourself first. And I do feel like some of you guys may be moving house as well. I do feel as if the place in which you are going to possibly have a relationship or have new connections in the year of 2021, I do feel as if there's going to be some new people coming in where you are starting to feel like this is just like a new venture. So your surroundings will look different essentially. So it may be you want to redecorate, or it could be you're completely moving home and the way you are interacting with your surroundings is changing as well. I do see this element of nature and expansion and kind of shedding your old skin, and I do feel like you are becoming it's almost like your energy is becoming more high class, in a sense that you are really focusing on things that are more on a higher level. Like you're not accepting, you know, scraps essentially. You are not accepting things that aren't on your wavelength and are less than what you deserve. So I feel like this energy is very centered around you and your energy and how you are giving that energy to other people. I do feel like you're growing. I'm hearing you're growing, you're opening up more, and your energy is going to feel a little bit confusing kind of crossing the threshold from 2020 to 2021. There's a lot for us. I mean, a lot of us are going to go through this immense energy shift, so I wouldn't be surprised. But I do feel as if the solar eclipse that's going to happen, I'm pretty sure the solar eclipse is going to happen, I do feel like it's going to be a massive change in the way you see yourself. And don't be afraid to ask for help. You know, ask the universe, ask your guides, or ask people who you feel like can really support you. And sometimes we just need a helping hand. You know, we can't always do things on our own. And if you are feeling a little bit lonely right now, just know that that changing yourself is not going to help. You know, coming away from who you are naturally, because you want to be your most authentic self. So you don't have to, you know, dim your light to fit in. So you don't have to shift your whole being to suit anyone else. You just want to suit yourself. You know, you want to focus on yourself, and the right people will be drawn to your light. You know, the energy is going to be confusing or confused if you are dimming to fit in, if you are accepting things that are less than what you deserve, essentially, because the energy wants to be directed in one space. It's kind of like it needs a direction. I do feel as if when you feel more like you are on a direct path, I think that's when somebody's going to start to come in. When things start to feel easier and when things start to feel like more straight lined and less confusing, that's what I'm hearing essentially. But I do definitely feel like there's a big energy around your solar plexus and your sacral chakra. So majorly around your confidence and the way people see you, and kind of not, like, basically taking up space, you know, especially if you are a very sensitive person and your energy sensitive, it can be difficult to expand your energy, because at the end of the day, your energy is already extremely expanded anyway, and it can be really hard to be seen. So making sure you're really focusing on what you want to do in this time right now, and how you can really, you know, adjust your energy so you are more in your own body. And things like this can be, you know, wearing crystals such as black onyx, hematite. They're really good. I always wear hematite when I am channeling, when I'm just out and about. It's really good at grounding you. Also, copper is really nice. I sell these copper spheres actually on my shop. They're in little baggies, just so they don't go oxidized. But yeah, I feel like it's really important for you to just ground, center, and know you're doing enough, essentially. Okay, so let's have a look at the type of person or the type of situation that you're gonna attract next year, or the year, you know, of 2021, whenever you're watching this. So we have Uranus, Mercury, Vertex, and waxing Gibbous. So lots of big energy. I feel like the person you're going to connect with, don't be discouraged, guys, if I'm gonna say you're not gonna attract a partner, because it's different for every single person. Your energy is going to constantly shift. So I do see you meeting somebody, but I do feel like it's more at the end of the year. For some of you guys, it could just be a friendship. Some of you guys, you could just be watching this for curiosity. A lot of you guys, I don't feel like are really interested in a relationship right now, because it could be like a really big situation, like a really big relationship. So if those of you who really, really want a relationship, I do feel as if for a small portion of you who has chosen this group, I do feel as if there is a relationship there. And I do see most likely an earth sign or a air or fire sign I'm picking up on. I do feel like I'm getting like mainly Virgo, Taurus, Scorpio, what else? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and those are the main ones that I'm feeling. Okay, so I do feel like something is being illuminated. We do have a karmic point, synastry, fated connection, and turning point. So that's what I'm feeling. For a lot of you guys, you are coming up to a turning point next year and in 2021. I feel like you are, sorry if I keep saying next year and you're already watching this in 2021, it's going to be very confusing for you. But I feel like the way you are approaching your love life right now is more about curiosity. You're curious about what's out there and anything that kind of can come towards you. And I do feel as if it's really important for you to focus on you and your alignment, because if you are feeling out of whack, the last thing you want to do is attract somebody in your life when you can't really handle your own energy right now. So I do feel it's really important for you to connect to your emotions and the way you speak, and speaking your emotions freely, and knowing that when you speak your mind, it's really important, and to be vulnerable. You know, you are as important as anyone else, and not everyone is thinking, you know, the worst of you, you know. And I do feel as if you may kind of have a big discovery in 2021. You may have a big discovery around technology or the way you use technology, and it could really help you to expand on some area. So it could be career, it could be in your lifestyle, it could be you suddenly go on Instagram when you've never been on Instagram before, or you, I don't feel like it's an online dating site, but I feel like you are connecting to technology in a new way. I'm not sure exactly specifically, but it feels as if you are discovering something new, and that could be how you meet your tribe or your new partner or a person. I feel like for a lot of you, I don't see a massive amount of a partnership in the year of 2021. So if you don't relate to this group and you feel like, I actually feel there's somebody coming, so maybe choose another group as well. But I don't feel like it's somebody massively here. I feel like a lot of you guys are still working on yourselves, and there may be somebody, but you may not actually be in a relationship with them in 2021. You might just know them and kind of get to know them. That's what I'm feeling. I'm feeling like new early stages, like a young child kind of energy. Like I'm feeling you're just discovering something and it's new, and it's more about self-discovery as well. And you are also learning how to deal with relationships. You know, you may have kind of had a bit of an epiphany, or you may have some sort of epiphany in the year of 2021, where you discover, actually, this is how I'm going to start loving from now on. This is how I want to be approached. This is how I want to be treated, and I'm not going to accept anything less, you know. So it may actually need you to come to this point so you can get to your partnership. So that's what I'm saying. It's kind of like more about rediscovery and discovering your potential and yourself. That's what I'm feeling. All right, so let's have a look at your connection. Let's see where you are, and then let's see the energy coming in, or it could be your future self. So let's see the energy of where you are. Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of snake energy. I feel like you're transforming and you're shedding just old skin that just feels outdated and feels too isolating. It feels like you are restricted and confined, and I feel like you're coming away from that. And I'd say your energy is being directed somewhere new. So I don't know exactly the right point in which it's being directed, but there's definitely something new that's being directed. Yeah, you're being reborn again, so that's possibly why I'm not picking up on one particular person. I am picking up on more on friendship. Yeah, exactly. They are definitely around you, but they're not fully coming in yet in the physical around 2021. But as I say, they could be, but it could be a new relationship. It could be something brand new right at the end of the year, possibly, I mean, maybe around October time, I'm feeling. I do feel as if there could be something protecting this energy. That's what I'm seeing. It's almost like the crocodile is protecting this egg. So it's almost like this person may be withheld by an old partnership, an old way of thinking. So you are also being able, you're basically learning how to deal with the situation you have now. And that's why you are being held back also, because you both are going through the same situation. And I do feel as if there's definitely some new energy. I mean, we had the black egg, so there's definitely, I'm hearing a recuperation. Your energy's being recuperated and shifted. So there's definitely something new. It's just kind of waiting for it to align. So obviously, everything takes its own time, guys, so just take it as it resonates, of course. All right, so let's have a look at your main energy. We have the Seven of Cups, speculation and opportunity. That's what I'm feeling. It feels more about you and the opportunities that you're going to have, and there's lots of different types of opportunities that you're going to have. I do feel like it's centered around your career a lot for this group. I feel like it's very much to do with money and how you are spending it, how you are earning it. It could be a career move. It could be an actual physical house move. I'm seeing it does feel a lot about you guys. Yeah, the moon, very deep energy. Ten of Cups, abundance and attainment. Lovely. I love that. Let's see if we can move that up there. Beautiful. So the sun is coming up. It's almost like you have to make a decision. So right now, you're being prepared for these decisions to come in. Okay, so we have the Emperor. Beautiful. So you could be meeting an Aries, fire sign. We have the World. Lovely. Let's get one more for the overall energy. Oh, two. Okay. We have the Dawn of Cups, discovery and curiosity. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm feeling. It's like nothing is out of bounds. That's what I'm hearing. It's kind of like everything is starting to become new for you, and this is going to be reflected in the world as well. I feel like we're going to be able to have a little bit more opportunity, which is good. And there's definitely an energy of like people coming in who are your tribe, because we have like four crystals here and they're all kind of doing like a little seance, a little ceremony in the desert, you know, as you do. So I feel like you may actually do like a seance in the desert, you know, that may be something that you're interested in. It may be to do with that festival. Is it Burning Man, I'm hearing? If that is actually going to happen, that may be happening next year. But I do see the more curiosity, the more you dive deep into what things are that you're feeling, the more you're going to recognize how to go forward. So essentially it's about self-discovery. So I'm hearing whatever I'm saying right now is guiding you, but you have to put the forward motion in as well. Okay, so I do feel as if there's a right time for everything. Right now is definitely a lot of deep intuitive energy kind of brewing underneath the surface, and when something cracks, it's going to start to be open. So I do feel like in 2021, it's definitely about rediscovering yourself, about new opportunities coming in career, and more like 3D elements, not so much a lot of love relationships, but I do feel like there is going to be some very significant people who will change your life. It possibly could be relationships as well, but I do feel like you could come into an energy of like a really strong father figure or a really strong masculine energy in your life could come in, who really just helps you to kind of change this new energy and bring in your new energy and allow you to be free and be yourself, which is really beautiful. So last thing, let's get you some tarot dice. Let's see what else is coming towards you in 2021. All right, we have the number 10 again, because we have the 10 of Cups. Yeah, so career, choices in career. We have the moon and we literally have the 10, which is like that. So we have the moon and we have the 10 there, and then we have this, which is Seven of Cups, which is Gemini, which is beautiful. So they're literally just clarifying everything we have here, which is beautiful. So lots of communications from different people in your career that are going to have a really significant deep effect on your life and your life path and how you're going to move forward. So I do feel like you are being directed towards people that are on your wavelength. It just may take a bit longer than what you have expected. Okay, so beautiful energy, guys. So if you guys would like a private reading, all my information is down below along with my crystal shop. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you have a lovely day and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, group number two. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your pick a card reading. So you guys chose this crystal bracelet here. This is hematite and black onyx. It's a really beautiful combination. It may be one that I'm actually maybe selling on my shop separately, but I'm not sure yet. But it has hematite and black onyx. Black onyx is so good for basically pushing away any negative energy. It's very, very perfect for like protection and everything like that. Hematite is really good for grounding you. So this is a really lovely combination. So this is really, really good for those of you who are very sensitive to energies and the world and, you know, certain people. If you're around people specifically like in work or a place you have to be around people, or people who just aren't on your wavelength, this is a really nice combination because it helps you stay grounded, but also it helps you to protect yourself from any energy that just isn't yours. Because especially if you are the sort of person who picks up on other people's energies without realizing, it can really help you to create this nice little bubble around you. But with this being in your love life, I do feel as if you're coming back to your center, or it's telling you to come back to your center, come back to your soul. I was going to say center, but your soul. Also your womb space. And this is for those of you who are male as well. You don't have to have a womb to go into your womb space. When you go into your womb space, it's essentially going into your safe space around your solar plexus. And it allows you to feel much more comforted. So basically, even if you don't have a womb, you basically put your hands on both sides of your stomach, around the bottom half of your stomach, and basically just connect into that energy. And it feels very powerful and very, very grounding. And as I'm doing it, you can probably tell a little bit in my voice that I'm feeling a lot more relaxed. So that is a really nice way of getting you grounded. And especially in relationships, if you are feeling really, really uncomfortable, I'm hearing unwell. So unwell doesn't actually have to mean in your health, but I do feel like it's like an unbalanced energy. So I feel like you are learning to balance out your energy and how you interact with others. Very important. So we're going to have a look into the tarot in just a second. We're going to have a look into your oracle cards first. So let's have a look and see the main oracle cards, and then we're going to have a look into the astrology. All right, so main energy we have around you and your love life. What way up is this? Show me. That way or that way? It is that way. Okay, beautiful. Like that. Okay. All right, so we have soul family, calling your tribe. You don't have to be... I can't speak. You don't have to do it alone. And then we have the gorgeous card of Aletheia. So I'm not going to look into the book for this one. I kind of feel drawn to, but I'm going to just do it intuitively. So I feel as if the main energy around this is basically saying you'll meet your person through your soul tribe. I feel like you guys, I'm hearing it's going to start off as young energy, and then it's going to grow. So essentially, you are going to meet someone or a group of people. I'm feeling a small group, like a small group of people who are really on your wavelength, who really suit you and suit your energy, and just connect to your soul. They just connect to your inside, not your outside. That's what I'm hearing. And basically, you are calling this in. The more you balance it out, and it's interesting how we have the black and white and then the white and black, which is essentially what this hematite is. It's like the I'm hearing defibrillation between the black and the white. So basically connecting to your higher consciousness and your human body, and basically balancing those out. So basically it's telling you to possibly meditate, to go out in nature more, to ground, to get grounded, and also to know that everything is being sorted for you behind the scenes. Okay, so if you are feeling a bit alone, you are feeling very confused and almost confronted, I'm hearing like the world feels like you are being confronted by the world. It's like, it's almost like you can't feel safe within your body. So there's definitely an energy of feeling safe within yourself and connecting to a higher power to help fuel this energy, and it feels really, really nice. I do feel as if you're going to get some very interesting messages in the year of 2021. You're going to feel very, very intuitive. Your energy is going to feel a little bit different. It's going to feel because you are basically ascending, it's going to be a bit confusing by the end of 2020, start of 2021. So obviously it depends on when you're watching this. I do feel as if there's going to be a massive shift within you, and it could change your career. It could expand your career. It could be a changing career. It could also be a change in your home where you live, because when you do this, basically it's going to draw you to the right type of people who are really on your wavelength, who are for you and only you. And that's what I'm hearing. It's like you're not sharing. You are obviously sharing is caring. You know, you are going to share, but it feels like this is just really specific to your soul purpose and your soul contract with somebody. And it could be a really strong feminine friend, a female friend as well. It could just also be somebody who you're just like, whoa, like they are, you know, they're going to be in my life for a very long time, and you'll automatically be drawn to them. So if you are in like a crowded room, you will be drawn to this one person. That's what I'm hearing. It's like you will gravitate almost like magnets like this. It's like the negative and the positive are drawn to each other. So making sure also that when you are around people that you're not being sucked into their negative energy. And if you are around people who are negative, making sure that you are, you know, kind of making sure you're not being around those types of people if it doesn't feel right for you anymore, because it's more about you can't really ascend and move forward in your life and draw in what's right for you if you are on that lower vibration. But it's just an element of, you know, learning and growing, and it's going to take a little bit of time, but it's going to be really beautiful. And I'm seeing around the fifth month of the year, so that is going to be May. January, very much, May. I do feel like some of you guys might be born in May, so hi to all my Geminis. it just feels really, really beautiful. This feels really, really lovely. And it feels as if you may meet a Leo as well. I'm picking up on you may meet a Leo next year, who's just really a big energy, like a really big, sorry guys, a bit of flower on my table, like a really big, yeah, just a really big energy. Like I'm picking up on someone who's just very supportive, and yeah, it feels really lovely. So let's have a look and see about your astrology and see who's coming in and what the energy is like. You've got quite a few cards. Well, okay, that's that way up. So we have Lilith. Love a bit of Lilith, I do. Got Aquarius. We have North Node, First Quarter, Virgo, and the third house. Okay, let me move these over. So it's definitely an energy of Gemini, and the way you think is going to be very different by the end of 2021. It's going to be like, wow, I'm like not even the same person I was last year or even a week ago. Okay, I see you expressing your sensual desires. I see you meeting somebody where you can fully express this. So that's really, really beautiful. And I feel as if there's going to be someone you're going to connect to on a very strong mind level. So it could be an Aquarius or a Virgo, could be a Leo as well. I do feel like your North Node is going to be the driver of this energy. So wherever your North Node is, that's going to be the main energy of 2021, or one of the main energies. The person who is an Aquarius or possibly has Aquarius in their chart, they could also show you what that North Node is. So say if you have North Node in Libra, it could be about your relationships and how you relate to others. And it could also be about you connecting to your individuality and being yourself in your connections. Okay, so I do feel like it's going to be a really big decision is going to be made in terms of your career and where your life is going. And I see that travel is going to be a really big thing. Even if travel isn't really accessible, it will be somewhat like a really big important thing for you on some level. And I do feel like Lilith is here to show you that there's definitely some things that are going to be revealed. And I do feel as if you have kind of had like a rough road with connections, I do feel as if this is kind of something you're going to be kind of coming away from. But if those of you who haven't really been on too much of a deep journey with your relationships, then maybe something is going to be uncovered and possibly is going to be able to be pushed away and to kind of, you know, moved off. So maybe you may have like a long-term friendship and then you start to think, oh, I'm not sure if we resonate with each other anymore. But it's going to be something that you're ready to let go of. So it's not going to be anything that's too intense, but it does feel like something that's meant to be for your energy, and it's going to feel easy for you. So with the third house, a lot to do with ideas. I think you're going to meet somebody who is very, very, I mean, I'm hearing sexy. There's somebody who their mind is very, very powerful. Let's see if this is a romantic connection. I am feeling a romantic connection. which is lovely. Yeah, it could be a Gemini. I feel like it's going to be after you've released some very deep thoughts about yourself. I feel like for those of you who chose this group, I'm getting like a really big insecurity around relationships, but also just around yourself, feeling like you're not good enough, feeling like you can't attract somebody or you're not able to. I just feel like there's an energy of really coming back to yourself and knowing your power and knowing you are extremely powerful and that you will attract somebody when it's the right time, okay? I do see that there's an energy of like revving a car and then like moving forward and then pushing the brake really fast and then moving forward and then pushing the brake really fast. So you guys might be fixed signs because I'm seeing that like everything you do with full force and then you pull back really quickly as well. It could be you have a fixed sign in your moon or your Mars as well, because the way you're approaching things is like all or nothing. So it's really going to help you to learn to, I mean, this is coming from a fixed sign, guys. I'm a Scorpio, so I feel you. It's coming from an energy of not pushing things to the maximum, really taking your time with this new energy. And I do feel like it's about communication, definitely. I do feel as if there's going to be some insecurities around communication is going to start to come up and you're going to start to resolve this. And this in turn is going to connect you to somebody who really is on your wavelength, who supports you, who suits you, who just feels really, really comfortable with you. This could be like two or three people as well. I do feel like you're going to meet somebody through, if it is a love connection, through family or friends or some sort of group community. That's going to be how you're going to most likely meet them. They have a lot in common with you. And I'm seeing someone who is creative, spiritual, and I'm hearing effective. Like they create like a ripple effect. So basically, you know, when people say like when you time travel, don't like touch a butterfly and the world will end, you know, that's kind of what I'm feeling. It's like this person does one thing and it changes like a really big way, and it changes things in a really big way. So this person has a very big energy that you're going to be connecting to, or the few people you're going to be connected to, very, very big energy. So before we look into the tarot, I want to have a look at the animal spirit deck. So let's have a look and see. Oh, wow. Okay, that was quick. Where you are. Exactly. It is making sure you are directing your energy in the right way. So not rushing things. Things will come to you naturally. If you feel the need to rush something, I feel as if you need to direct the energy somewhere else, whether it be exercise or into a project or into an idea or exploration of something. Don't push it onto anyone else, because I feel like this could push away some connections, because you are definitely realizing a lot about your intuition and who you are. So you may feel the need to kind of push this because it may feel a little bit uncomfortable because this is new, but this is all really, really good. You are coming into stability and power. Beautiful. So this is the energy that's coming towards you. It could be a person or two people. It could also be your energy in the future. I actually feel like it's someone who's very, very stable. And you are definitely going to be more comfortable with your intuition and your spirituality in the year of 2021. And there's definitely some roadblocks that are going to be moved. I feel like there's going to be somebody who comes along and helps you shine, helps you be more noticed. So I do feel like in your career or in your projects, I feel like somebody's going to help something like zhuzh up. It's going to zhuzh something up. It's kind of like when you have curly hair. I mean, I have curly hair, so I know. But basically, if you have... when you touch your hair and you zhuzh it up to like make it bigger, especially if you do have curly hair, because as a girl, we need to do that very often. It's kind of like zhuzhing it up to make it bigger. That's what this person is doing. And they're helping you to show your true colours, who you naturally are. So it may be come with a couple of triggers, but that's okay. There is roadblocks, but there's also, you know, open doors for you. So I do feel like you may have to burn some bridges with some people to help you get to this point. But that's okay, you know, that sometimes that has to happen so you can get where we need to go. And it's all meant to happen. It's going to be very easy. You know, sometimes, I mean, obviously I'm not going to say your whole year is going to be like butterflies and rainbows, but it does feel as if you have a lot of control over this, which is beautiful. So main energy, yep, Queen of Cups coming into your authenticity, realizing your authentic self, which we have authentic, which is lovely. And we have virtuous as well. So really being aware of your own thinking and what suits your path and not anyone else's. Okay, so let's see what else wants to come through with the tarot. For those of you who are asking, this is called the Acura AF tarot. I think it's by Prism and Fleur, I'm pretty sure. I know a lot of you guys have asked where these oracle cards are from. Okay, similar to group number one, you both have the Emperor in the World. So I do feel as if you are coming together with a masculine. Those of you especially who are feminine, masculine's coming towards you if you are attracted to that energy. If you are not, I do feel like this could be a friend or someone who is a colleague who just really helps you to stay grounded. I'm seeing like a woman and then a man like pushing the woman's shoulders, saying like, it's okay, like, don't worry. You know, it's not aggressive. It's very like... it's very almost fatherly. It's like guiding the person. Obviously, don't worry about the genders, but I am seeing that is that sort of dynamic happening. So it feels like the yin yang balance. So if you are a masculine, but you are, you know, a woman, you could meet somebody who's also, who's a man, but feminine, you know, like it just depends. Like, don't worry too much about the genders. Whoever you're attracted to or whoever you connect with in this year, I feel as if they're going to just suit you so well, and it could amount to a relationship as well. All right. Ten of Swords, you are releasing deep, deep, deep karmic lessons. And it says only upwards, which is great. So you're releasing anything that's just like old, gross, yucky energy that you just don't need anymore. And you're like, ew, go away. So anyone who you feel like you are in competition with, it feels like you may be tested a little bit, and I feel like you need to keep coming into your own lane and what you deserve, okay? We have insecurity and recovery, and then we have resentment and competition. So there's definitely like a battle energy going on. It may be within like a university or within a course or something like that, where you feel you need to have to perform to be this type of person for somebody else or for yourself. But you just got to be you, girl. Like, if you can't manifest something right now, that doesn't mean you're not going to manifest it. It just means it's coming the right time for you and nobody else. And I just saw an orb. That was weird. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of orbs today, which is very interesting, which is quite unusual for me. So that is your reading, guys. I do feel as if there could be an Aries or masculine energy coming towards you. Aries, Leo, Sag, it does feel like Aquarius energy as well, and also Virgo, which we had previously. I'm pretty sure we had that. If we didn't, that's what I'm picking up on. Could be a Taurus as well. It could be a boss, actually. If you guys are in work, I do see it could be a boss also. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you would like to check out my private reading rates, please have a look down below if you're interested in a private reading with me. All my information is down below also for my crystal shop. Thank you so much for being here and for spending your time with me. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, group number three. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. So you guys chose this beautiful Howlite bracelet. This is part of one of my collections for sleeping. Howlite is really, really good for sleep. So this is going to be one of the bracelets that should be up in my shop very, very soon if it's not up already. And yeah, so let's get started with your reading. So for you guys who chose Howlite, I do feel like because this crystal is very peaceful, it's very gentle, it's very kind of very adjusting. So I do feel as if you guys are really learning to adjust in your love life. So you guys are really feeling quite peaceful about love. You're feeling possibly a little bit lost, a little bit stuck, a little bit confused, but that is normal because that's something that, you know, we have to go through before we get to the good stuff. You know, sometimes that has to happen. And sometimes the confusion comes before the enlightenment. So we have to sometimes feel confused so we can get to where we're going, because at the end of the day, we can't be constantly perfect all the time. Otherwise we wouldn't learn anything, which kind of sucks, but there we go. But I do feel like as if you could be dreaming about your person that you're going to me. I do feel I get a very dreamy energy from this group. I get a very kind of soft light energy. So I do feel like there's going to be some newness around dreams and subconscious and karma and things like that. Lots of newness around that, which is really nice. So that is beautiful. So plop that there. Okay, so let's have a look at the tarot in just a moment. Let me get some oracle cards and then we're gonna start this reading. First card out we have Answer the Call. What is your soul calling you to do? Beautiful. I love this. Very mermaid. I feel like very Piscean from this group. Very, very pretty. So I love that. And then the other two cards we have. Oh, three cards. Wow, you guys have got a lot of new energy coming in. We've got the Storm. We have the Medallion. Let me move this over. Okay, the Medallion. And we also have the ring. Okay, so I definitely feel it's really interesting because this is the only group who has a charm on their bracelet, and we literally have a little charm here. So that is very synchronistic. I feel as if you guys are the ones that are probably the most forward in your love lives. I do feel as if there's some massive shift happening. And whenever I see this ring, I always get this energy of this happening, like something shifting, like things turning, things moving, kind of like I'm hearing like a train going like that, starting to move off the tracks, moving off into something new. It's kind of like if you guys have ever been on the train and you're kind of sitting waiting for the train to move, because sometimes, you know, trains are early to the next stop, so they have to sit and wait, and then you don't know when they're going to start to move off. So that's kind of the energy that I'm feeling, is you guys are really waiting for something and you're kind of feeling a bit like, ugh, I'm kind of in the storm right now, don't know where to reach for, where to go. But I do feel as if you guys are going to the right place. It just might feel a bit bumpy getting there, okay? But I do feel like when you get there, you will know when you will meet this person. I do feel like there's a massive energy of a future partner in this group. I do feel a strong bond between two friends as well. One of those friends could be your partner as well. And I do feel as if there's some sort of threshold that you're crossing. I feel as if you have so many different ideas, or you're just feeling very confused in your brain right now, that just things are just not clear, and that's okay. You know, you will find peace, you will find a cleansing type of energy. It just has to be a little bit, you know, shaken up before you can get there. Essentially, it's like a snow globe. It's like you have to shake it up to, you know, get the snow falling. You have to shake it up to get that new perspective, and that's what's happening. It's like your energy's been really shaken up. So I'm not surprised if you guys are feeling a little bit confused, shaken up, just stressed. It basically is telling you to go towards where your soul is calling you. So if you are feeling like you've done a lot of things for other people, you've essentially kept doing things other people have wanted you to do, you've struggled to kind of focus on yourself, this is telling you to go for it, girl. Like, if there's anything that you want to do, do it now or forever hold your peace. That's literally what I heard. That's amazing. I'm picking up on a marriage energy very strongly from this. We do have the ring, so I'm hearing, ow, I just hit my hand, ow. That was so random. It is funny because I actually hit my left hand, which is the hand that has the ring on it. Okay, T. Yeah, I do feel as if there's an energy of, like, if you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. That's the energy. I feel like you're meeting somebody who possibly an ex-partner of yours or an ex-friend will be like, oh, wow, maybe I should have, you know, put in more effort. Maybe I should have been there for that person. You're like, girl, I do not care anymore. I got my man's, I got my woman's, I got my person. You know, it's like, it's not even about something that you've gained or somebody that you've gained. It's almost because you are so, I feel like, happy with just being yourself individually and really just focusing on your journey. The more you focus on what your soul wants, the more comfortable you're going to feel without having a partner. But it doesn't mean you're not going to have somebody. I do feel there's a strong partnership bond happening, a yin yang type of situation. I definitely see a baby as well. I'm feeling it could be yours, or it could be, you know, your partner's, if you are not of the baby making organs, if you have any of the baby making organs. Okay, so obviously you don't have to have a child as well, guys. It's obviously for everybody who wants a child. That's who I'm focusing on there. All right, so we have the fourth house of Cancer. This is the house of origins. Here is where we see our home, bloodline, feelings of safety, comfort, mother figure, tradition, and lifestyle. It also shows where we come from. I belong. Full moon, very Cancerian. I love that. We have Aries, and we have Neptune. Wow, very Piscean. I love that. Okay, so somebody you could be connecting to who is very fiery. I'm getting very, very hot right now. As soon as I pulled that Aries card out, I was like, "Woo, I'm getting hot, girl." So I feel as if you're going to be connecting to somebody who is very grounded, very fiery, very passionate. They have a lot of ideas. They're very spiritual. They are very dreamy. They love to dream up new ideas. And they're somebody who doesn't get distracted too easily. So they're somebody who looks at the bigger picture, and they're always on the bright side of life. I'm hearing, always look on the bright side of life. That's what I'm hearing. And we have the full moon here, which is beautiful. You're harvesting energies, you are getting your blessings, you're achieving, and it says energy peaks. You are literally going to get to the peak of something, and then you're going to be like, wee, like a roller coaster. You're going to like get to the point, you're like, oh my god, we're going to get to the top. And then, you know, that point where you kind of, if you're on a roller coaster and you're like at the point and you can't see what's the other side, that is where I feel like that's the start of 2021 for you. It's like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Then you start to move, kind of like, as I say, like the train moving. It's definitely energy of safety as well. You could be meeting a Cancerian, a Scorpio or Pisces, somebody who's very watery. I'm getting Aquarius as well, but mainly Pisces and Aries from this group. Really, really strong, passionate energy. This person has a lot of dreams. They're very, very inspirational. They're somebody who is very artistic, very creative. I'm seeing something to do with their teeth. Like they could have like almost vampire teeth at the front of their teeth, like quite pointy. The way they speak can be quite sharp, not in a horrible way, in a way that's like very powerful. There's somebody who has a very strong Mercury. So they could have Scorpio Mercury, Aries Mercury. What else? Can you show me what else? Taurus Mercury, somebody who just fiery. So could even have Leo Mercury, you know, but I do feel like this person's very, very sensitive. And it's, oh my God, I just realized, guys, this moon charm is literally the same as the moon that's on this card. If you guys can see that, let me just see if I can show you. Okay, look at this. This is crazy. That is literally the same. That's really weird. I love that. That's amazing. Oh my God. We love a good synchronicity, girl. Okay, so I definitely feel like you're going to meet your person in your dreams. Your dreams are going to be so weird before you meet them, or they're going to be the complete opposite, depending on what you normally have. If you normally have like really weird dreams, your dreams are going to be like very still and very plain. And then they're going to be like, boom, they suddenly come into your life. I feel like they're going to be, it's going to be such a random meeting. You could meet them at like McDonald's or something. That's what I'm seeing. Obviously, if you go to McDonald's, if you don't go to McDonald's, it probably won't be random. But I do feel as if it could be in a community, a group. It could be, it's just like I'm seeing you surrounded by a lot of people who are supportive of your heart and your soul, and they have like the best intentions for you. So it does feel like a supportive environment. So in whatever way that is, it could even be around your house. It could be when you move house, it could be that, because we have the full moon as well, like conclusions. So you may move house. It could be around your home. It could be your daily routine. It could be when you go to the gym or when you go out walking your dog, you know, something like that, like a really random meeting. And it just feels like a comforting meeting. It feels like you feel very safe and comforted, which is absolutely beautiful. I love this. I love, love, love this. Okay, so let's have a look at your animal cards, and then we're gonna have a look at your tarot as well. So let's see where you are right now. That was quick. So lizards, you could be very connected to lizards right now, and that kind of reptilian energy, very intense, very raw, very, very kind of like bringing everything to the surface. You know, nothing is hidden with lizards, I don't feel. I feel like they're very much there. You know, like when you see them, you're like either scared of them or you just love them, you know, could be either one of those. The new energy is the egg. I mean, lizards do lay eggs, I'm pretty sure. So there's definitely an energy of like birthing something new. And I'm literally seeing a lizard giving birth in my mind, which is so interesting. And it's like they've been holding this egg for like a really long time. And now it's like a new birthing. It's not even just like a birth. It's literally like a whole, a birth. It's a whole being born. You know, it's a whole new you. This could be your person as well. There could be somebody who you've never met before. I feel like for a lot of you, it's somebody you've never met before. They are definitely somebody who is intense. They're somebody who can deal with darkness. They can deal with intense feelings. And there could be a counselor. There could be an art teacher. There's somebody who has seen a lot of dark energy and they can deal with it. They're really, really good at dealing with it. And both of you are coming out of the darkness. This person, I feel like, is being guided towards the light, and you are this light. Obviously, switch around the kind of positions if you feel the need to, but I feel as if there's definitely energy of like nurturing and coddling yourself and just doing things that are on your wavelength so you can grow easier and quicker and, you know, grow more essentially. So when you are in this energy and you come to this kind of almost conclusion, this pivotal point, you will then start to feel much more confident within yourself, within your dreams and your desires and where you're going forward. And I feel like you're wanting to be seen more. You're taking up more space. You're allowing yourself to just be who you are without any worries about what people are thinking of you, what are people seeing in you. You're just being yourself. And you may be somebody who possibly was a bit of an outcast or feels a bit kind of like you've been casted out. And I feel like you're now coming into an energy of being really, just really at home within yourself, which is really, really lovely. Okay, so let's have a look at the tarot. Main energy we have is the Five of Cups, dwelling and avoidance. Okay, that's really interesting. We're going to get some clarification on that. I feel like this is the energy you're at right now. Okay, I don't feel like this is the future. This is like really, I'm hearing very central energy, very present energy. So this is kind of what's happening right now. We're going to get some clarification on that. Okay, so we have Uranus, we have Aquarius, and we also have the fourth house again. feeling at home within your insecurities. That's what I'm hearing. It's like facing your insecurities head on and not avoiding them. That's what I'm hearing. Okay. If you are feeling something, you are meant to feel it. It's meant to be there. It's not just there for the banter. It's there because you need to deal with it and look at it. All right. So that's what I'm feeling. I'm sensing a lot of like stars and moons. So if you get drawn to those, that could be extra synchronicities. Wow. We have so many fives. Okay, so we have the Five of Cups, Five of Swords, Five of Rings, insecurity, recovery, resentment, competition. So there's definitely energy of like, I can't do this, I can't do this, I can't do this. But girl, you're gonna come out of this, okay? I do feel as if this is insecurity around actually manifesting somebody. And then we got the Nine of Rings, abundance and fortitude. Exactly. So this side of the energy is like old. Okay, this is what you're trying to release. This is what you are releasing right now. And I mean, Uranus is like a really big energy. Uranus is like the energy that people don't like a lot of the time. It's the energy of like, holy crap, I'm going to see everything about my life right now, right in front of my eyes. And we have the Four of Cups. So you are coming into completion. It just kind of feels a bit confusing right now because things aren't exactly how you would have expected them. So I'm going to move that over there because I feel like that's like kind of the older energy. So this is the newer energy that's coming in towards here. So we have eagerness with the Spirit of Swords. We have the Spirit of Rings. Oops, and we also have the Sun. Perfect. So I feel as if you're coming into full circle. Essentially, you may have gone through something that has been reoccurring, and you're like, how the hell do I stop this? Essentially, the only way to stop this is to realize what possibly is triggering this or what's going on. And if you don't know what's triggering it, just keep being you. Keep being yourself. Be authentic, be kind, be loving to yourself and others. And that is the best that you can do, because at the end of the day, this energy is going to keep repeating until you realize whatever that cycle is. And I feel like by the probably about March time, this is going to start to shift into more happiness, more abundance, more freedom. But right now there's definitely energy of like looking at things deeper, but it doesn't mean it's a bad thing. You know, this is just a little bit of something that you're investing in. It doesn't mean it has to be uncomfortable. It could just be you are seeing things from a different perspective and you're like, oh wow, you know. And it could be in terms of a connection. It could be somebody's kind of come out your life, or family's left your life, and you're like feeling very avoidant and distant. And after a while, you start to realize, actually, I'm worth more than what is somebody not going to give me or going to give me. So I'm going to focus on myself, and I'm going to really push myself to, you know, reach my highest potential and really be productive as well. I feel like you guys are going to be focusing on a new project as well, which is going to help you refocus your energy. But it feels really good, guys. I feel like there's going to definitely be somebody who's going to help you with this as well. And I do feel like when you come out of this energy, it could be naturally or more consciously, I do feel as if there's going to be that new energy coming in for you guys. I'm also hearing Caribbean calcite. I keep looking at this little guy here, so I'm going to recommend that to you guys as well. It's a very beautiful, just a really satisfying, calm crystal, and I kept looking at it, so I just feel like that could be the energy that you are looking towards as well. And things are falling away, so don't be surprised if you may lose connections, but they're not meant for you if you know it's meant to happen, guys. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this reading. If you'd like a private reading with me, or you want to check out my crystal store, all the information is down below. Thank you so much for being here and spending your time with me. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye. Hello, group number 4. Thank you so much for being here. Let's get started with your reading. So you guys chose the beautiful rose quartz, the classic, the beautiful energy. So obviously rose quartz, as you guys know, if you don't already, it's to do with unconditional love. It's to do with expansion of your heart chakra. It's to do with really good sleep. So this is going to be in my sleep collection. It's really, really good for sleep. Raw rose quartz as well is really good for sleeping too. It just helps you to calm your body, and I can say for a fact that this helps me fully, and I've used it for my own, you know, personal use. So highly, highely recommend. It also is gonna, I do feel like you're gonna be really working on your heart chakra when you are connecting to your love life, when you're in your relationships. I feel like you're learning to open your heart, be more vulnerable, and really focus on how to love, you know, how to love what's right for you, what's your love language, what makes you feel safe, what makes you feel comforted. All those lovely things. I do feel like addictions, you're going to be pulling away from those as well, or working on them at least, I feel. Okay, so we're going to have a look at the tarot in just a moment. We're going to have a look at the oracle cards first. So the first two out, three, are Trust the Niggle. What is the niggling feeling trying to tell you? we have the nectar. Oh, this card doesn't normally come out. Oh, it looks like a bracelet. That's so cool. I don't know if you guys can see that. That is so interesting. Oh my God. And then we have Anima Mundi. Okay, excuse my pronunciation. Okay, so I do feel as if the energy around the niggling feeling is what I was saying about your energy around how you are connecting with addictions and things like that. So how is this coming through for you? It feels as if there may be something that you need to adjust, that you need to kind of look at, and that could be that niggling feeling. You know, it could be a part of you that thinks, I'm not sure about this connection right now, or I'm not sure about how to go about this. The most of the time, the best thing to do is wait it out and see how you feel, because you don't want to rush something if you're just not sure. So I do feel that's going to really, really help you, is to just kind of adjust your energy as you go, and to know that everything is meant to be for you. So if something comes out of your life, that's okay, that's meant to happen. And it's really, really important for you to notice what is your energy and what somebody else's. And I do feel you guys are going to be really fruitful in your love life in the year of 2021. I feel like it's going to be a lot of different connections coming in. And I do feel as if there may be a baby as well for those of you who are already in relationships or who are wanting to get pregnant. I do see a baby for some of you guys. I do feel as if there's a planned pregnancy as well, guys. So don't be scared of that, of an accidental pregnancy. I don't see that happening, or a blessing of a pregnancy. I do feel as if the energy of the niggling feeling is kind of like you're needing to tune into your body and really focusing on your intuition and how you feel in any certain situation. So if you're getting a niggling feeling that something is kind of wrong, maybe ask the person how, you know, they're feeling and how they're going about it. And if it could be essentially like, I don't know, like you're feeling like, is it, oh wow, sorry guys, hang on. There's a bit of a weird thing going on. Okay, I do feel as if there's a really strong connection around you guys and how you are focusing on your energy. This feels really, really good. This feels very positive. I do feel as if you need to connect with your intuition more and how you really feel, and not rushing and pushing and forcing. Just really tune into your intuition, what feels right for you in that moment. And if you're not too sure, wait it out and work on that patience. I do feel like you're growing into this new person, so really be patient with yourself. I do feel as if you guys could be coming more into spirituality or leaning more into religion or trusting your faith and your own judgment towards yourself, and kind of like, I feel like you're just trusting yourself more with decisions. I do feel like there's going to be one very strong kind of option that's going to be kind of drawn towards you, and I do feel like you're going to decide what option to take. You may be somebody who kind of struggles with kind of making decisions. I do feel like this is something that you're going to really, you know, work on, and something you're going to just start to feel much more decisive, I think. And there's going to be a lot of people with their eyes on you, I'm seeing. So you may be somebody in the public eye, you may want to be, you may be somebody who is on YouTube or Instagram, and you may be a big influence on people. So I see that you are going to be expanding on this. This is going to be your business as well for some of you guys. I feel like your business is really going to expand. And I see you guys looking more into astrology and possibly astronomy as well in the year of 2021. And I just see there's a new side of you that's being revealed. So I'm not entirely sure of how this is going to come about, but I see this is going to come through naturally. And I see that you're going to start to feel much more able to trust yourself in any certain situation. So I feel like you're going to be able to be more spontaneous, I'm feeling. Okay, you're going to possibly meet someone who's quite spontaneous as well. So let's have a look at the energies and the person you possibly could be meeting. So we have a Gemini, we have Sagittarius, we have the 12th house, pretty sure that is, the Sun. Wow, you got a lot of cards, guys. One second, let me move those over. We have retrograde, so it could be 12th house in retrograde or something like that. Something like that. Waning crescent, and we have waxing crescent. So first, let's have a look at these two cards. I'm getting redrawn to these. So I feel as if there's two sides of you that basically, you have two minds, I'm feeling. You have the one mind that's like, let's go over here, and the other one's like, let's go over here. So I feel like you're going to start to become more grounded in your energy. So I feel as if you guys are going to get a lot of inspiration, and you're going to really allow this inspiration to come towards you. It could be somebody who's also very inspiring, somebody with a lot of ideas. And I do see as if somebody you're going to meet is very creative, and you're going to be really creative this year. I feel like you're going to allow your creativity to shine, allow it to flow, allow it to be, you know, there at the forefront, and learn to trust it as well. I feel as if you are definitely somebody who has a lot of ideas and you're going to really execute these, especially in your career. You're going to be releasing a lot of outdated beliefs about yourself and how you want to interact with others, and your confidence as well. I think you're going to be much more confident. You may be a leader in some sort of aspect. You may want to be an inspirational person online, or you could be wanting to be some sort of group leader. So it could be in a community or some sort of group that you're interested in. It says, with the 12th house, it says, this is the house of intuition and the unconscious. Here is where we can see transcendent experiences, hospitals, prisons, secret agendas and hidden enemies, as well as unknown possibilities and one's weaknesses. This house is also associated with long-term confinement, seclusion and psychic abilities. Okay, so I feel like for you guys, it's learning to surrender your control, which I know can be very difficult, because I feel like your ego can get in the way a little bit. But if your ego starts to be like, you're never going to get anyone, you know, you're never going to attract anyone, don't listen to that. Just divert your energy or meditate or, you know, relax and just put your energy somewhere else. I do feel as if you're going to actually meet quite a few different people on different times of the year. And I do feel as if the air sign, earth and fire is really coming through here. I mean, all the signs are really there as well. Pisces is there as well. I do feel as if there's an energy of really surrendering with your 12th house. So if you have any planets in your 12th house, I'd highly recommend looking into your chart and seeing possibly what house is in that chart as well. That could be giving you an indication of what the sort of things you're going to go through in 2021 around your relationships. And it's definitely something that's going to come back around in terms of your confidence. So there could be something that knocks your confidence a little bit, but you're going to get back up straight away and you're going to be stronger than you were before. I'm hearing that song, it's called Stronger by Britney Spears. I'm picking up on that song as well. So it's interesting because we have the waxing and the waning. So it's almost like you are kind of going up and down a lot this year. I feel like it's an energy of like, okay, who am I attracted to? Who do I want to connect with? And I feel like you're going to be very decisive with who you're going to want to have in your life. So I think there's going to be a really strong energy around deciding you're not good for me, you're good for me, and kind of like being very decisive with that. It could also be you're learning to be more decisive in your energy. You're learning to figure out who is there for you and who isn't. I do feel like you could meet somebody through learning, through a new kind of inspiration, whether you are in school, college, uni, or you're on a new course, or you're learning something new within your work, or some sort of opportunity comes up within career. It feels like something within that kind of situation, especially with the 12th house being here. It does definitely feel like a really big energy around healing and spirituality and closure of your old karma is what I'm feeling. I do feel as if you're going to possibly reignite some connections with an old friend or old relationship that you possibly feel you need to kind of come back to. Because I feel like especially with the retrograde, you're gonna like recycle some old energy and recycle is a good thing. It's kind of like there's tiny little bits in there that need to just be readjusted, that you're gonna start to kind of re-look into it and have more fun. I feel like you're gonna have more fun next year as well, or the year 2021, depending on when you're watching this. You're going to have much more fun, and there's going to be a lot of dating going on, I'm feeling, for you guys. A lot of new energies coming through, and I do see some sort of long-term connection coming in as well. Alrighty, so let's have a look at where you are right now, and let's see where you're going to be, or the energy that's coming towards you. So where are you right now? Perfect. You guys are rediscovering yourself, and you're seeing things from a different perspective. You're kind of seeing things from above, and you're starting to realize what your beliefs are and what you want to follow, and things that really engage your attention, and just things that are just on your wavelength. I feel like you're really bringing that in, and the energy that's coming towards you has lots of different elements. So this is about being proud, working on your ego, but also working on your intuition and speaking your truth. So this is kind of like realignment I'm seeing, like you're realigning your energy. And you may even have three people, could be like a Pisces, a Leo and a Sag, or something like that. It could be like three people, or it could be all types of yourself are kind of coming into this lovely energy. And we do have the Hawk underneath. So very similar energy to the Eagle. This is more lighter. The Eagle can be quite intense. So it could be like a sudden realization of something. And it could be like a sudden energy of like, okay, I have to do this, I need to do this, and making a sudden decision. We also have the Peacock, that's kind of that was kind of left behind when I picked up the deck. So you're being seen more and you're wanting to show up more for things. You could be learning to possibly be more on time for things as well. Maybe you're a bit late to things or you're a bit early or whatever, you know, whatever you feel is an insecurity with you. I feel like that's kind of what you're working on, is something that you're bringing into this energy. That is very, very interesting and just really deep and beautiful. And I feel like this is something you've needed to do for a very long time. Okay, so let's have a look at your astro dice. Ooh, okay, we have Scorpio, fifth house, Mercury. So we did have that retrograde. I'm pretty sure we have retrograde. Did we have retrograde? Let me just double check. I'm pretty sure we had retrograde. Can't see it now. But if we didn't have it, I do feel like it's definitely energy of like things coming up. And you'll definitely learn to speak your truth. I do feel like you could meet a Scorpio within your dating life. This is definitely about dating and reignition of energy, reigniting energy. And it could be a sensual connection that you have with somebody. But the fifth house is about dating and, you know, connections that can be quite strong and long lasting. So I do feel as if this is going to be somebody who really speaks their truth with you, and you have really lovely, long, deep conversations with them. And you really converse about things you're really passionate about. So the main energy is the Eight of Rings. We have resourcefulness and positive potential. Perfect. So that's kind of what you're going to be seeing in this person that's going to come towards you. And this person doesn't have to be romantic as well. It can be a friendship. But I do feel like some of you guys who want a connection, there's a lot of newness coming in. And we have the energy of change. There's definitely some insecurities with you around your relationship. So I do feel like that's going to be sorted out. And you're going to start to be more accepting of other people in terms of how you are in relationships. So when you are saying you're being more accepting, you are starting to become more confident with what you give and take in relationships and how you're being seen. There's definitely an energy of responsibility, and there could be a challenge around responsibility. But I do feel as if you are now kind of coming into a nice new energy. I mean, we have the Five of Cups in the reverse. So it's no longer looking at the past, no longer looking at things that you are avoiding. You are really seeing things in a positive light. I do feel like it's just a really nice shift going on. Right now, you are definitely going through change. And because we have positive potential, emphasis on the potential, I do feel as if there's the energy hasn't come in fully yet. It's definitely more in 2021 and more towards summertime. I feel like this could occur. I definitely feel like it's going to be somebody coming through with something you're passionate about. We have the Ace of Wands and the King of Rings. So this is somebody who is very mature, they're very responsible, they're very stable, and there's somebody who is going to just be a really nice energy in your life. They could be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, somebody who could be around your career as well, who just really assists you and gives you a lot of advice. And there's somebody you can really lean on. And I feel like I'm hearing the song Lean On Me. Is that the right lyrics? I'm not sure. But I do feel as if you guys could also be getting tattoos as well. You could also be a tattoo artist or an artist or graphic designer. And you could really kind of, I'm hearing, pull the potential out. You could really like pull your weight around this artistic endeavor as well. And this could be how you meet your person as well. But I definitely see that you are releasing a lot of energy around challenges, and your life is going to feel a lot more lighter around your responsibilities around relationships. And I'm hearing don't take responsibility with other people's insecurities, which rhymes. A lot of my messages rhyme when it's guided, but I do feel as if don't take on other people's crap, essentially. Like, it's not yours, and you just have to focus on you and how you're responding and how you want to interact in that certain connection. You know, if there's somebody in your life who just doesn't suit your energy anymore, have a little think about what it is and maybe think that maybe it's not the right connection. But I do feel as if your energy is definitely transforming. You're transforming the way you speak, the way you communicate in your relationships, and you're definitely going to be doing some deep diving in the next year. But it feels really good. It feels like major transformation around your dating life. And I do feel like for those of you who are, you know, sensually active, I do feel as if you guys are going to be thinking more that you want more of a longer committed relationship instead of like a fling. But you could have a fling if that's something you're interested in. But I feel like a lot of you guys are thinking more deeply about how you interact with others intimately as well. Okay, so that's really beautiful, guys. I do see a strong marriage happening as well, a strong engagement. So I do feel that could be happening for you guys as well. new energy coming in, new breakthroughs. I do see that you guys have a lot of willpower, so keep going, guys. It's going to get better, okay? So thank you so much for watching and spending your time with me. If you would like a private reading, all my information is down below along with my crystal shop. Thank you so much for being here. Hope you have a lovely day, and I'll speak to you soon. Much love. Bye.